Did you ever wonder why different compounds smell so different? There's no mistaking the unique aromas of mothballs, rotten eggs, or nail polish remover. Part of the reason we can tell these aromas apart is that the molecules responsible for them are quite distinct. The main ingredient in mothballs is 1,4-dichlorobenzene, whose structure is seen here. Hydrogen sulfide is just H2S. And the aroma of nail polish remover comes from a compound called acetone. Taste and smell are our only two senses that can distinguish the chemical nature of environmental stimuli. For smell, differences are distinguished by olfactory receptors in the nose. 1,4-dichlorobenzene fits perfectly in one receptor, while hydrogen sulfide is recognized by a different receptor, and acetone by still another. The unique size, shape, and other properties of each molecule help determine which receptors recognize it. Biologists are still learning about our sense of smell, but what they do know at this point is that when a molecule binds to an olfactory receptor, it triggers the transmission of a nerve impulse from the nose to the brain. The brain interprets the signal, responds accordingly, and hopefully also stores the information in long-term memory. Now we'll try testing our sense of smell blindfolded. Bottle number one contains a compound whose chemical formula is C11H15O. Let's see what our expert smell tester thinks this is.
I know that one. It's spearmint gum.
Okay, let's record your answer. Here comes compound two.
Boy, this is easy. That's dill. We use it in the summer when we're making pickles.
Are you sure? That compound also has the formula C11H15O.
Yeah, I'm sure. Somebody must have stuck the wrong label on it.
Well, if you're sure, I'll add that to the table. Now tell me what the last bottle smells like.
This is easy. I know that one too. That's ginger root. My dad uses it when he makes Chinese food.
Last chance. That's the third compound with the formula C11H15O. Are you sure it isn't spearmint or dill?
I'm sure. I'm positive.
How can three compounds with the same formula have such different aromas? Are they really the same compound? How could that be? Our olfactory receptors send different signals to our brain when the molecules are different. The signals are different. Our brain smells three different things, so it must be true that the molecules are different. We're going to explore a new idea about molecules. We've seen part of this word before. The prefix iso comes from the Greek word for same. We used it in the word isoelectronic to describe two atoms or ions with the same electron configuration. Isomers are compounds with the same molecular formula but different chemical and physical properties. We'll take a look at different types of isomers. First, we'll look at structural isomers. Then, we'll finish up with a discussion of stereoisomers, including optical isomers. By the time we finish, you'll be able to explain why three compounds with the same formula smell so different.